Jurassic World Evolution is a bad zoo sim. I really wanted to like this game, but boy has it been disappointing. I'm not going to explain every little thing it did wrong, just the single most important thing it fails to capture. Have you ever played Zoo Tycoon? When you boot up the game, you're given two play options, play scenario game and play freeform game.
Now pay close attention, because freeform game is the one we want here.
In a freeform game, you pick your starting funds and map before you're released into the world with a limited selection of animals, buildings, and equipment to create exhibits. The point of this, the gameplay, is to manage your limited resources and gradually unlock more and more content through achieving a higher park rating. That's it.
That's the game.
Jurassic Park Operation Genesis,
the spiritual prequel to Jurassic World Evolution,
follows this exact same cycle except for three interesting twists. Your starting dig site was random. You could only unlock 5 out of the 9 available dig sites per park, and your island was randomly generated. So what did this mean? It meant every new game, you would not only have a different island to play on, with constantly changing geographical features and barriers to play with or around, but a slightly different roster of dinosaurs to build your park from the ground up with. Every game was different. The soft grind, constant map change, and mild restrictions kept things fresh. Overall, for both games, you'd have a park built and a 5-star rating with everything unlocked in maybe 2 hours. Games were fast, replayability high, the grind satisfying, and I kept on coming back again and again for more. Jurassic World doesn't do any of this, though. And I can't understand why. The entire game revolves around a career campaign-style mode. No random maps, no free mode. Content is unlocked as you progress through the campaign, and by campaign I mean you go back and forth between the same 5 islands, while being constantly assaulted by tedious and sometimes arbitrary contracts that further gatekeep content. Let me just run through all the things you need to do to unlock dinosaurs and dig sites in this game. I have a list here. It's quite long. Build an expedition center, achieve a 3-star rating on an island, grind the reputation high enough of whichever division of your park, security, entertainment, or science, that is currently preventing you from just researching your ability to go look for a specific set of dinosaur bones. Afterwards, build another expedition center on another island that you unlocked, and then, let's see here, do all that stuff I just said over again on this new island times 4. Wowie zowie! Who has time for all of this? Alright, now, what is it again we said you had to do in Operation Genesis to get new content for your park?
Achieve a higher park rating!
My first playthrough, it took about 40 hours to unlock everything. Now, if I was running through this as fast as I possibly could, I could probably beef it down to maybe 4 or 5 hours.
But I don't want to do that.
In its current state, it's just so tiresome. It's boring, pointless tedium. I don't want to grind a million hours playing Catch the Chicken with some dork from marketing because he's holding the dino DNA of the Supersaurus ransom until he thinks my park's Twitter page has enough likes. Only so I can then finally have the privilege of digging up the dino bones and doing the grind I actually want to grind. Until you can be let loose on a random map with a handful of dig sites, random dinosaurs, with the only thing limiting content and your park's development being its rating, Jurassic World Evolution will always be a tedious game to go back to. So is it just completely unsalvageable? Is this the part where we grab our MREs, our high-fiber bars, and go down in the early 2000s bunker to play nothing but Operation Genesis? No, not at all. Jurassic World Evolution has all the tools necessary to change and succeed. A large roster of dinosaurs, plenty of attractions and guest buildings, dozens of dig sites, gene modifications, hide color options to customize your dinosaurs, and a committed development team that's proven they're willing to go back and fix their mistakes. They fixed the drooping Stegosaurus's tail. It used to droop. It was droopy. But that's also why I may be coming off a little harsh. This game has everything it needs to become successful. The game is Jurassic, with raw tyrannical potential. But the question remains, will it retain this momentum and evolve, or will it be satisfied with its mediocrity and go extinct?